Ayan, so hello! Welcome back sa aking vlog. Kamusta kayong lahat? So, last week tuloy. Nung nakaraan, I don't know when na, nakalimutan ko, nag-upload ako ng unpacking of Melt. And I hope na may natutunan kayo doon. And ngayon naman, i-share ko yung study notebook ko. As we all know, we are now in the stage na malapit na yung pasukan, tapos nagla-lock session tayo. Okay, so dun sa lock session na yun, we have different outputs and activities to answer in each day, diba? So I am sharing this is my own work, okay, based dun sa mga lock sessions that I had. I'm sharing para din may makuhanan kayo ng idea. And I hope na meron nga kayong makuhang idea sa vlog na ito. So, let's start. So, ito yung LDM 2 for Teachers Module 1, the course orientation. So, Lesson 1, course overview. So, the activity number 1 is reflecting on the course. This is my answer. This is my reflection on the first session of our LAC. Okay, so yan, basahin nyo na lang, I will not read it na. And then, LDM 2 for Teachers Module 3A. So why Module 3A na agad? At saka bakit yung Module 1 ko yan lang? Because sa Module 1, this is the only thing that our facilitator requires us to answer. Kaya ito lang yung sagot ko. Okay? And then, sa Module 2, I did not include the Module 2 here because I have a separate copy of that, the unpacking of Melt. This one is the Module 2 of mine. This is my own work as well. Now, how did I come up with these answers? Please watch my first vlog on about the unpacking of Melt. I will just include or just write or type rather the link on the description box. So just a little bit, write the English, write the Melt that you are doing or that you want to unpack, and the number of days taught. So one of the main reasons why we are unpacking Melt is to meet the number of days taught. So 5 days siya. So it cannot be na sa day 1 classify, ang ituturo natin is classifying sounds, tapos sa day 2 classifying sounds ulit, sa day 3 classifying sounds ulit. So it prevents the repetition of lessons. Kaya tayo nag-a-unpack ng Melt para hindi nabibigla yung mga bata. Okay, hinihimay-himay natin yung Melt para dahan-dahan yung approach, para dahan-dahan yung pag-atake sa Melt. So those are the reasons why we should unpack the Melt according to the number of days taught. So kung 5 days yan, 5 days yung pag-unpack na gagawin mo. Kasi anong ituturo mo sa day 1 that is related to this Melt for you to achieve this? Ulitin ko, anong ituturo mo sa unang araw, sa pangalawang araw, sa pangatlong araw, sa pang-apat na araw, at sa pang-limang araw for you to achieve the Melt? So that is the question when you are unpacking the Melt. How will you achieve this one? Ito, paano mo yan ma-achieve na Melt? Siyempre, dadaan ka sa proseso, sa knowledge, remembering, application, yun, yung sa Bloom's Taxonomy. So, sabi ko, like, little bit lang, pero ang dami ko nang nasabi. Just watch my first vlog about this one. Okay? So, these are my Module 2 output. I made 4 subjects for the Module 2, Unpacking of Melt. So, that's it. Now, let's go back to my study notebook. Ayan, so dahil tapos na ako sa Module 2, yung unpacking, eto na kami. Kaninang umaga, we had our session about the Module 3A designing instructions in the different learning. So the lesson one is understanding the different learning delivery modalities and defining the modalities. So as we all know, we have different modalities now kasi nasa new normal tayo. But the first thing there in the module 3A is to define in your own words the different learning modalities. So these are the words that we need to define: face-to-face learning, blended learning, and homeschooling. So these are all my own words according to how I understand these modalities. So for me, face-to-face is the usual classroom setup that we are doing over the years. So I did not elaborate it anymore because from the word usual, diba? Diba yung usual? So hindi ko na siya in-elaborate. So blended learning, when we say blended, we are using supplemental videos, resources around the web, and it also includes simulations. Well, I really love simulations kasi this is one of the techniques and strategies in teaching that our generation needs kasi yung mga kabataan ngayon, nabobored na sila sa laging nakaupo when we are having face-to-face learning modalities. Kaya napaka-importante ng simulations. So, sadly, ngayon hindi natin siya ganun mamamaximize yung simulations. But did you know we can have simulations na uploading videos lang? Upload lang tayo ng videos na susundan nila para makapag-explore sila, lalong-lalo na sa pagdating sa science. Did you know na kaya pa rin talaga mag-science experiments even though nasa new normal tayo? Kasi yung mga batang yan, panoorin mo lang ng video, panoorin mo lang sa YouTube, kayang-kaya nilang sundan yung experiment na yan. So yun, that's a blended learning for me. And homeschooling, ayan, student, the parents will be their teachers. As far as I know, sa homeschooling, yung teacher yung nagbibigay ng assessment. The important thing in homeschooling is basta mapasa ng bata yung assessment na binibigay ni teacher. Yun lang yung requirement doon. Okay? So, I did not teach homeschooling. I have an idea about the homeschooling because I had many friends na they choose homeschooling nowadays in the new normal. Okay, next. Am I too fast? Sorry. Activity 3. Deep diving into distance learning plus LAC. So, the activity here is to rank the learning modalities in your school or in your region or in your division. So, what I chose is I rank the deliveries or the modalities that we will be using only in our school. So, we have 3: the modular printed, the modular digitized, and the online learning or the synchronous. So, for me, the easiest is modular printed, and here is my reason. So, in this module 3A, we do have different answers here. Okay, so, pwede ko namang isend to sa inyo yung soft copy. But you will just change it, edit it, kasi kung hindi naman kayo magkakandak ng modular printed. But I doubt, kasi lahat tayo ata may modular printed. Ayan, so, these are my reasons why, bakit yun yung pinakamadali, kasi will not be using internet here. But also, it has advantages like the feedbacking and mastery of the lessons because we don't know kasi mahirap mag-feedbacking ngayon. Kailangan, hindi natin kasi sila nakikita. So, yun. Number 2 is modular digitized. Yung sinunod ko na madali para sa akin kasi sa FB group to, i-upload yung mga soft copy and supplemental videos. But the problem here is we all know that some parents are working. So how sure we are na magaguide nila yung mga bata kahit mag-send tayo ng supplemental videos, how sure we are na mapapanood nila, diba? But it's good kasi at least mababalikan nila once na it is uploaded in the FB group na. Okay, and the last, online learning, simply because, as we all know, internet connection. So, yun. Next, my answer in my study notebook. Next answer in my study notebook, interventions. So, here, ito kasi yung pinasa sa amin na sasagutan. Nag-self-learning kami. Ayan. So, after ranking, asan na ba yun? Ayan, so this one, learner group and targeted intervention sa activity 4. Pero, you will just group the learners based sa division nyo, region nyo, or school ninyo. So, during our survey in our school, I think and I believe na tatlo lang yung grupo ng learners namin. Yung learners without parents or household member who can guide and support their learning at home. And I believe magkakapareho tayo dito. And no access to devices and internet, that's one. And then struggling readers. For sure naman itong tatlong napili ko na group, meron din kayo nito sa school ninyo, di ba? So, ito yung intervention na naisip ko because nobody or their parents are busy working and no one would guide them in their studies. Kaya ang intervention ko is follow up them every day to be sure that they understand the lesson. So, we cannot follow up them na face to face. Syempre, ano pa rin to? Via call, text, chat. So, ang importante lang dito, may nangangamusta sa kanila. Kung kumusta na yung lessons, nahirapan ba sila, or what. So, yun yung intervention na naiisip ko para ma-make sure pa din natin na nag-aaral sila. And then, this one, sa mga walang devices and internet, pwede naman tayong mag-upload ng offline video so they can watch it even they are using data. Kasi, kapag in-upload na natin yung offline videos sa FB group or sa GC, finorward natin, less na yung data na gagamitin niya kaysa yung link sa YouTube yung ipapasa natin. So, yun yung intervention na naisip ko doon. Next, I know you have lots of intervention then, but as I am saying, this is my opinion and this is my answers. You can edit it anyway if you want a copy of this. Okay, so, struggling readers, for me, is dahil hindi tayo face-to-face. Kung face-to-face, isasagot ko dito na papaiwanan ko yung bata para pabasahin siya sa hapon. Pero that's impossible because we are in the new normal setup. Kaya I just write here na call the help of their parent to be more patient in teaching na lang. And send supplemental videos so that the learners will understand the lesson by watching it. Kasi hindi lang naman siya nakakabasa eh, pero nakakaintindi siya. So, mali mo, visual learner siya. So, send ka lang video. At least, doon sa video, hindi niya kailangan magbasa. Diba? Mapapanood niya and maiintindihan niya yung lesson. Diba? Kasi wala naman siyang babasahin sa video. The problem is, hindi siya reader. Kaya, kaya niyang manood, I believe kaya niyang manood ng video at intindihin yung video. Kasi ang problema lang naman niya ay hindi siya marunong magbasa or the student struggled in reading. Yun. So, yun. Next, lesson 2 na tayo. Designing lessons and assessments in different LDMs. So, these questions are from the module 3A na pinasa sa amin. Ayan. So, dito siya galing. Ito, pinasa na kasi sa amin lahat ng sasagutan namin. And then, ayan. These are the questions in activity 1. So, I just copied it and pasted it here. Then, I answered it based doon sa this one, DO42S 2016. If you want the copy of this, just type it in Google and it will pop up. Okay? So, lalabas na siya. Kasi, dyan daw manggagaling yung sagot. Ayan. Write down your answers in the following questions in your study notebook. So, yun, binasa ko. and then copy paste yung I copied and paste the question and this one. Siyempre copy paste 'yan. Ito, hindi ko na sariling sagot. It's a copy paste kasi sabi doon base sa DO 42. Ayan. So I just copied and paste all the questions and answers here. Ayan. So that's all. And in activity number 2, sequencing learning task, ito 'yon. Sa activity 2, ito yung pinapagawa. Meron ditong list of learning tasks, then you will just identify which section of the lesson these learning activities can be presented by placing each task under the appropriate column. So ayun, for example, this one, wrap up activities, from the word wrap up, di ba? Wrap up means tapos na, you are wrapping it up. So after the lesson siya. So yan lang, nilagay ko lang siya in the proper column. Ayan. So that's all for activity number 2. Ay, kinopy ko lang ito, review previous lesson. Syempre, pag sinabing review, before the lesson yon. So I just put it the before the lesson. Wala namang nag-review sa after the lesson, di ba? So dito talaga yon sa before the lesson. Okay, next, hindi ko na to iisa-isahin. Ayan, next is, ayan, palakihin ko ng konti, baka hindi pala nakikita, I'm so sorry. Ayan, so palakihin ko pa. Ayan. Next is activity 3, reflection. If you would notice, I just highlighted objectives, content, and procedures because according here, sa activity number 3, highlight which part or are accomplished after the lesson is delivered. So, I assumed na after I teach my student, i-highlight daw kasi yung natapos mo. Siyempre, yung objectives, yung content, learning materials and resources, I did not highlighted it. Kasi di ba part ito ng lesson plan, pero or daily lesson log. But when you are teaching, hindi mo naman, you are using visual, pero hindi mo ko naman kasi sinasabi sa bata na, oh, ito, kinuha kong information na to sa Google. Diba, ganun. So, it is just part of the daily lesson log, pero hindi natin siya sinasabi sa klase, kaya hindi ko na siya hinighlight. Ayan. So, it's up to you kung i-highlight nyo, that's okay. Pero sa akin, hindi ko siya hinighlight. Okay? Next, activity number 4 na tayo. Ang dami. Ayan, read the handout, designing lessons in DL. Now, in your study notebook, recreate. So, ito yung hindi ko pa natapos. Recreate and accomplish the following table. Kasi hindi pa to na-discuss sa amin kanina. Kaya, I don't want to assume. Kaya hindi ko muna sinagutan and I am waiting for our facilitator to say that this should be answered. Okay? Kaya hindi ko pa siya sinagutan kasi hindi ko alam kung paano siya sagutan. But according to the instruction, recreate. So ibig sabihin, gagawa ka ng sarili mo. Okay? Recreate and accomplish the following table. Then choose one lesson from SLM for students that you have on hand. Imagine that you will deliver this lesson to your learners through DL. In the second column, identify which of these tasks are already present in the SLM. In the third column, identify which was to be presented. Okay, so titignan mo lang sa module if they are present or not. Ayan, review previous lesson. Check if already present in the SLM. Kung present siya, check mo lang. And then dito sa additional remarks, can be done via voice calls, household partners. So, yun lang. Check mo lang dito sa second column yung part ng module. Kung present siya sa module. Madali lang naman pala. So, gagawin ko na to, guys. Ayan. So, just check it. Ayan. Copy, paste, then check. Yan lang naman yung sinabi ditong gagawin. Pero sa third column, i-identify mo siya kung paano siya present. kung supplementary learning materials ba siya or technology mediated resources. For me, dapat talaga hawak mo yung module dito as it is stated in the instruction. Ayan, kunwari, review previous lesson, check. Kunwari, nasa module yon. And then, ilalagay mo dito, paano nangyari yung review previous lesson sa module. Ayan. Activity sheet ba siya? Internet-based resource ba? Ganon. So, pipili ka lang dito naman yung nang isasagot. So, madali lang din. Ayan. So, yan lang yung aking study notebook hanggang module 3A pa lang kami. And I hope you subscribe and pakipindot na notification bell. Kasi, tomorrow, pag nag-module 4, 3B na kami, and module 4, I will upload my answers here. So, ayan. Thank you so much. I hope you have learned something, and all the learnings na, kung may learnings man kayo dito, I hope na mai-apply nyo din sa paggawa ng inyong study notebook. Ayan. So, that's it. Thank you. Watch, like, subscribe, share the video, and press the notification bell para sa study notebook, module 3B and 4. I don't know kung hanggang kailan yung laki. And I will upload here my portfolio. Yan yung mga outputs natin. O mga remaining outputs, I will also upload here. So, stay tuned. Thank you. Remaining outputs, I will also...